actually wondering on what topic should I speak because the DM already didn't tell me. But I want to ask you a question before I start this presentation today. How many people here have ever made a video in their lives? Okay. Why did you make a video? Which video did you make? All of you can speak together, I'll listen to you.
That's my work.
Audition? Okay. Of what? What video did you make?
All the time.
All the time, what?
Some people
are
recording
and
finding
it
recorded.
Okay, that's good.
Cool.
Hope you're not recording me.
I made videos of my own speaking when I was in rehearsal.
That's great.
Doing rehearsal.
Okay, anyone else?
Sometimes I also made videos when I'm dancing on the other side.
I'll let you see that.
Events, speeches, I mean, both food.
You make videos. Great.
Exactly. Yeah, whenever I've traveled, you know, I've made quite a lot of videos off roading in the hills.
Alright. But why do you actually make a video? Why just take a picture and upload it or send it to someone? Why do you actually make a video? Or why a video is it?
To really live the moment.
It's
a lot of context. A lot
of context. And what is that context?
Audio.
Okay, it has
a sound. A lot of photographs.
Okay, great.
It connects with more of your senses than just senses.
So she said senses and experience. You were also seeing something?
I'm also seeing the same. The real emotions you can see, you know, in later on.
Sure. Okay. So, what we have established here is, a video is always better than a photograph. Let me take you to the older times, not too old, just 5 years ago or 10 years ago. How we used to share data at that time? We used to capture the data and share it with a select audience, probably through writing it on a piece of paper or taking our photographs and sharing it with people. But that has changed considerably now, right? So I'm not just talking in perspective of being a professional speaker. I'm not just talking in terms of your daily jobs. You can also consider it for your matrimonial resumes or then profiles. By the way, I practice what I preach. So what I want to say is that the way we share data with people has considerably changed. Earlier we used to share, as I said, our limited data in the form of probably a paper or pictures through a select audience, and they, according to the very few needs they had, used to select those services or what we had in ourselves and give us the required opportunity. But the way we share data these days is totally different. What we do is we just upload it on the net on a shared medium, and everyone has an access to it. Now let me tell you one thing, handshake is very important, as was told by Pallavi. But there's a good chance now that you might not even get a chance to handshake with people when you're going for auditions, when you're applying for interviews, because they will judge you based on your first internet profile that they will see. HR interviews are abundant these days. Earlier, the process of hiring a person was that there used to be an HR interview in which the HR manager will judge you on your speaking skills, on your demeanor, on what are your soft skills. But these days they do not do that. They will probably look into what is there of you on the web, or probably if you have submitted a video profile, or if you have a video on the internet, or if you have something which is more in a digital form, and not just in the form of a paper. Even if you're submitting your resume, you need to use the right keyword these days. But there's a very good chance that if you have a video resume, video profile, your chances of getting to the next interview increases by 63% in developed countries and by 37% in developing countries, according to a survey by BCG. So how many people here have any video of them on the internet? Any video? What is health application?
Pushing the Toastmaster stages.
Yeah, whatever has been recorded in professional speakers, that's it.
That's that. Given. Last videos, okay. If I would ever would want to love, learn dancing, I'd probably go to the Reena or Google. Because I know I've seen their videos on the internet. I've seen them dancing, that's another thing in our conferences. But I've seen their videos. I know that they're good dancers and it's just that how they can teach me will now determine the other thing, but I know at least they know how to dance. But when we say that we are professional speakers and we don't even have a profile on the internet, if I would have been a prospect or a client for you, I will never hire you. And if they don't hire me, then I really don't feel rejected because I've not done my work. So just 2-3 weeks ago, or probably last week, only Rupinder posted on a professional speakers group that he would want us to submit our profiles. How many of us submitted our profiles, by the way? Alright, and out of that, was it a video profile or just a paper profile? Medium, right? So it was, so you don't need to submit a resume to him, right? You need a profile that a client can see. Obviously, it also adds impact. That shows your professionalism. That you're also submitting a document, but if you're going for speaking and you're not speaking, then I don't know how we will be able to compete with the other people who are there in the market, because there's no dearth of professional speakers in the market, right? If you ask in Toastmasters, you'll get 6,000. In District 41, you'll say, yeah, I'm another professional speaker. Let me just come and try, give it a try. But the other person who's organizing a big setup, why would he want to take someone who has not even spoken in front of anyone? So my recommendation to all of you, whether you're looking to get another job, whether you're looking to get married, or whether you're looking to build a video profile or a professional speaker profile, it's mandatory that you make a video of yourself.
But nowadays, few companies are only recruiting a video resume, like Accenture and all.
That's a good point. That's now my turn, so. Sorry. Okay, so his point is right, and I actually also gave that while I was describing the part. But now our focus should be how do we actually make a video profile and what do we need to do to build one such profile for ourselves. So I propose that from now, if we start working, all of us should have at least two profiles. One basic profile of 2 minutes and one very enhanced version of our professional speaking videos. Clips which have enhanced version of our professional speaking videos. So this 2-minute video is very simple. What you do is, you take a high definition camera, stand in front of a white background and talk about your skills that you have honed after working in an industry, or probably if you are making it for professional speakers. Talk about your experience speaking. Talk about what you have learned. Talk about what you can make your audience learn in 2 minutes. And we can all work through that. Just make it in front of a white background, write your speech well, make sure that you learn it by heart so that even if it's required to repeat it multiple times, you are able to do it by using the exact right words, and the one who will edit it will then have the luxury to take several clips from the best videos. I can help you with that. Let's work on that and make sure that in the next 2 weeks we have this ready. Next, which is very important, it's kind of a proof that you're giving to your prospect or the client that you're not hiring a naive person. You're hiring someone who has already spoken on valid stages, who have experience speaking in various platforms. For that, you need to start working from now. You need to work for at least 3 to 4 months. You need to visit several clubs, several places. In Toastmasters and International, at least for this group, there will be several opportunities for speaking in various events, in various conferences, in our division conference, in our annual conference of oration. If Rupinder and Rubal gets us an opportunity to speak probably in our training event or in another speaking event, then also. But for this video, you have to collect clips of you speaking on several stages, even if you have photographs. Now, when I was collecting my photographs, I was myself bewildered. I had so many experiences. And all of them were thanks to Toastmaster. I had so many experiences. All of you have such experiences. There was such a good clip that I got from the ATM that Mukesh conducted, in which I just conducted a very small exercise. Probably Pallav will get the best shot from there, because she was a very good anchor in that particular event. Or probably Mukesh was also there giving his thank you speech. Then I have my speech from the last oration conference which I took. Then I spoke in Nepal. Then when we were there in US, I got a chance to speak with them also. So just making an amalgamation of what all experiences you had till now, even if you put them in a clip, they will give the right impression to the person who is hiring you that yes, this person has done something which will be beneficial. If this person comes and shares his experiences, it will be beneficial for a group. Making a video profile is not just important, it's indispensable for all of us. If we are trying to become a professional speaker, we can make simple videos very soon, but to make an elaborated, enhanced video, you need to work hard. You need to collect experiences. Set a time frame. Let's help each other. Let's make best use of this platform, this club, and get our video profile soon.